Okay, Joe, what about, how do you make, big opportunity with Oklahoma State coming up, but how do you not make it too big?
Yeah, I'm really happy to be playing Oklahoma State. We need to kind of have a measure of where we are, and this will by far be the most competitive team we face. It's the first time we'll be underdogs going into the game, at least in my opinion. Maybe I'm wrong about the other games we played. But, yeah, we just need to be challenged. And we've got this tournament, and then that kind of gets us ready to see where we are going into the next tournament at Fullerton and then in SEC play. So it just gets tougher from here. But, yeah, I don't want our team to just get too emotional about the game. Just play it and let's gauge where we are. I feel good about our team. I think we have a great chance to win a ball game. And but yeah, it's really important for us to play against a team like that.
Joe, what have you learned about your team through 11 games?
You know, I like how athletic we are. I think our kids are having fun playing the game. It's a good group that plays well together. I think we have a good balance of veterans and youngsters, and I think our young freshmen are doing a good job and learning every week and getting better. And I think it's a team that can compete. You know, I like that our offense has taken some pressure off our pitchers, and our pitchers have thrown really well. But when you only have to go out there for 5 innings, that helps keep us healthy as we move along. And so I'm really pleased. I know we can get better. I definitely know we can play better, and defensively, I think we're getting better. But I do think we have all the pieces in place to have a really good defensive team.
What's gotten into Rylan Wiggins at the plate? You told us it was coming.
Yeah, yeah. You know, it's funny. When I recruited her, she was in high school. She hit home runs all the time. You know, she hit home runs. She ran well. She played a great shortstop. And now there's a big learning curve. You go to college, and I'm really pleased with Rye, and she's worked really hard at it. Just a little small detail about her swing and her posture within her swing and working all summer on it. Just something really tiny that makes such a big difference and has really helped her confidence.
What's a Remy status? She had a pitch, right?
Yeah, she's now got cleared.
What's the deal?
So she had... She broke a bone in her hand. No, thank goodness it was her non-throwing. It was her glove hand. And it was at the plate, getting a live at-bat and ended up getting hit by a pitch. And it's the last thing you want to see is your pitcher up there hitting, getting hit by a pitch and break a bone in her hand. And but our pitchers throw hard, so, you know, it was unfortunate. Really a tough way for her to start out the season. But she just got cleared, so the good thing, it wasn't her pitching hand, and so she's been able to do some things and stay healthy and get some reps. But what a big, huge deal coming into this weekend and next. I don't know how much we'll be able to throw her this weekend as she tries to get herself back, but I know she was really excited to come back for California.
How long ago was that?
It was a good 4 weeks ago.
Wow.
Yeah, because the doctor said maybe 4 to 6 to 8 weeks. So it's been probably 4 or 5 weeks.
How pleased are you with names not named Herzog and Lee in their production at the plate, Coach? It seems to really be helping your offense.
Yeah, we talked about it all last year. You know, we were scrambling to try to turn the lineup over and get back to Herzog and Lee, and for us having that kind of production at the middle and bottom of the order is just huge. And I think Morgan Smith's doing a really nice job, and Rylan Wiggins, I'm scared to move her in the lineup because you don't want to jinx the kid. She just is so good though right now. And the production we're getting at Katie Dack, our freshman, that's a kid coming into the season. Coach Snyder said, listen, I'm going to tell you right now, we have to find a way to get this kid as many at-bats as we can get her. And so then we're thinking, okay, how do we do this defensively? And she's a catcher, but, you know, she's a freshman. She's got a lot to learn. Macy Allen has swung the bat well and gotten us some big hits. So for Dak, we said, okay, let's try to work her in the outfield. So she's just learning. You know, we're just trying to find a place that she can be in our lineup every day.
Joe, you told us before the year you were wanting people to play two positions. Have you been able to do that, and have you been able to get the young players in that you wanted to with your smaller roster size?
Yeah, you know, it's interesting. We said we were going to put Wiggins and Woolley, just flip them back and forth. And then Wiggins went out there and played second base like I haven't seen in a long time. And so I changed my mind, which is my prerogative. But, yeah, I really wanted to switch back and forth. But, boy, Rylan Wiggins is playing a phenomenal second base, and she's getting great reads. And she never really played there before. So to see what she's doing and her range, and she's in the right place at the right time, I think second basemen often go unnoticed, but if you don't have a great second baseman, people know something's off, but they're not sure what it is. And so Rye is just a really heads-up, smart player. So we've kind of stuck in that rotation, of really not a rotation, just keeping her there. We have, yeah, worked some outfielders in and out. You've seen that. Trinity Cannon starts for us, but we make sure to get Gallegos some innings there in case something happens with Cannon. You see Haley Lee and Macy Allen rotating there. You see Mariana Torres at first base and Shay Ackerman in left and first and pitching. So I think for the most part, we have done what we set out to do, and I think it makes us a better ball club.
Maybe something silly question, but mentally, how do you handle the weather this weekend until Sunday when it warms up a little bit?
Oh, yeah. Today's miserable. I mean, I almost gave up on you guys. I was like, I'm not walking 10 minutes over here. It, you know, it's so tricky with the weather because you get so excited to play and be at the ballpark, and it's such a great feel. And then the forecast is 37 degrees and drizzly winter mix. It's just not what you want to play softball or baseball in. So that can really mess with your mind a little bit. And hopefully it'll gradually get better as the weekend goes on. But honestly, there's just nothing like being at the ballpark on a nice day. And I know I'm biased and partial, but there's nothing like it. And being at Davis Diamond. So we'll deal with the first couple of days, and hopefully it gets better.